Here's a simple baby slipper that you could knit up on the machine. Again, I'm working on the bulky, so any of the bulky machines should work out for this. And if you, like I said before, if you donate and it's going to fit somebody someplace. I cast it on 10 stitches and I knitted 45 rows. Now you're going to take the beginning here, but you're going to turn it so the purl side is facing you. And then you're going to grab, and if I had done this with live stitches, I would have just picked up the live stitches. But I'm going to grab one loop of the cast on and hang it on these needles. Well, having a hard time getting that third one, so I'll just do these two. And then the last two. I'm going to hang another weight on again. And for this machine, it's going to knit the stitches right back. For those that do not knit back, just push them back into the forward working position. Open the latches as needed. Now I'm going to knit 15 rows. You may want to do a decrease. And what I'm going to do is just take my three-prong transfer tool, move those first three stitches on the end in one. I'm going to take the other three on the opposite side. So I'm decreasing two stitches across the way. You really don't have to do this, but it's up to you. And then I'm going to knit one row, but because I'm at tension dial 4, I'm going to go up to tension dial 10. Knit that last row so I could latch toll bind off. For those of you that are already on the upper end, just hand manipulate that last row is all. And then as I have shown in other videos, just latch off. Then I will sew this to the bottom. I'm going a little bit fast for myself here. I will sew that bottom piece. That's going to be the sole of the slipper. And then I need to tack it down as well, or else these are going to fall off the baby's foot. Now that I have this all bound off and I have the piece like this, I'm going to take this edge that has the yarn coming off and I'm going to fold those right sides together. And then I am going to start sewing. The last 15 rows in place to the side of the what was 45 rows. Now what I'm going to do is, this is where I had put those two ends together, and I'm just going to go across, actually let me come down one more stitch here, and you don't have to, you could just weave these in and out, but if you just go through the purl bump, going across one row to get the yarn over on the other side, then we could start sewing the other side. And of course, don't pull that tight. So now I'm going to take the other edge there, and I'm going to sew that in place, and then I'm going to sew the toe in place. Now I'm probably going to have to gather, I'm going to do a couple stitches together to get that toe to line up just right, and that's really no big deal. So as you see, when I get up there, that's not going to match up correctly. So I'm just going to pull it in a little bit to make that fit. And in the end, it's going to look like this. Now I do need to put a little tack there. Maybe I'll tie a little bow, being that it's a boy's slipper. You may have to go up just a little bit more so that it fits around the foot. Or you could even put a snap or a button on there if you want to. For a button, well, you got to make it small so it fits through the hole. Or I probably should have done an eyelet right in there so that I could have put a button on and then would have buttoned it right in place. So here I did the bow, and then I took the two loops and made another knot so it doesn't come out. And as I was looking through my buttons, I come across the jingle bell, which would be nice, but it's a choking hazard. So I really do not recommend putting a button on these small of slippers. If they're a little bit older children, then yeah. So I just put the yarn through an area there, do my overhand bow, take the two loops, make a knot out of that, and then cut the ends so they match with the loops. And there, now I got me a pair of small slippers to put in my bag to go to the hospital.